So recently I was in Mexico last week for the WBC Women's Convention. Great time, great people. Ricky?
So you follow, you're a big fan of girls boxing, Ellie?
I support boxing. Lucille Riker used to train in this gym.
I didn't ask you that, Ellie. Are you a big fan of girls boxing?
I'm a big supporter of boxing.
Okay, good.
And I want to see boxing do...
Actually, the fans are the winners.
In the amateurs, you know what David told me? That in the amateurs, the women boxing were more impressive than the men.
In the Olympic trials?
Yeah, you see? You told me that.
I don't believe that. I don't believe that at all.
You know why? I saw a lot more body shots from the women than I did from the men.
You see, the women work hard. But it doesn't have, let's be real, it doesn't have the following that the men have. It's not on TV.
Yeah.
I think they should get more of a shot, like more of an opportunity. But here's the funny part. So afterwards, I go back to the border. And I didn't have a passport. And I gave the border patrol my ID. And they look at the ID and they go, where were you born? And I said, Jerusalem. And a guy panicked a little bit and he goes, what's the last country you traveled to? And I said, China. So he's thinking, wait a minute. You're trying to sneak into the US, you were now in Mexico, and you were in China. I need proof you're a US citizen. I told him, Google me.
And he did?
No.
He didn't Google you at?
You know, he's like, wait.
So
I need
what
a...
happened?
He started searching in a computer with my name, if I'm wanted, if I'm this. After 15 minutes, they let me in.
How'd they let you in? I'm surprised. With ID?
Yeah. With that, I never again, I gotta take a passport.
You have to.
I know.
Either you take your ID passport or a regular passport.
I could have been stuck in Mexico right now. I love TJ.
You're lucky they let you through.
I love TJ. People were super nice.
You're lucky they let you through.
I know.
Finish with a job. Get out of the
But Ricky, now I understand why you love going to TJ.
Why?
Because people were so nice. Listen, they work hard. Cost of living is very low. A cab for an hour ride was like 10 bucks.
And you know, normally people cross the border to come and work in San Diego.
I know.
And they go back.
It took me an hour and 40 minutes to cross the border.
And they work, they come and work here for minimum wage, which they're happy.
But over there, one peso, $10, $5. But I will say this, life is not easy, but they still have a good time. And
it's like any part, like my country, I'm from Honduras. The life is slow over there. Too much poverty. Like Salvador, Guatemala, Mexico. You know, life is slow over there. It's not as speedy like New York or California.
But here's the thing. Mexico and the news have such a bad reputation. But when I was there, I felt safe. I felt cool. Nobody...
Oh, of course, because you had the drug trafficking wars, you know?
But that's everywhere. Look, we're here in Van Nuys. You want me to take you three blocks up? I can show you the action. It's true. There's bad everywhere. If you want to emphasize the bad in Mexico, you can. But I'm telling you, I was there for a few days, super nice.
Yeah.
And the convention wasn't bad. WBC.
You were there for 3 days?
Yeah. Even longer, 3.5. The WBC.
Yeah, you didn't bring me my pills, man. I needed the blue pill.
You didn't text me. I told you, Viagra.
Yeah, of course, cheaper.
Cheaper.
Give me.
Anybody who wants to send Ricky Funes Viagra pills, what's the address here at the gym?
I don't even know the address.
he's advertising.
Ricky wanted me to buy him some pills. The address is 14420 Friar Street, 14420 Friar Street, Van Nuys, California. Ricky, what blue pills did you want from Mexico? Oh, stay tuned. Please report that coming, Melissa, back reporting.